Oh,
damn.
Welcome, folks. This is the stream here for LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens on the channel. We're going to be doing a Let's Play live stream again this time. This is part three. I'm your host, Nathan P. Butler. You can find my Star Wars Timeline Gold, the most comprehensive Star Wars chronology available anywhere, over at StarWarsFanWorks.com/timeline. You can find the two podcasts I'm involved with, Star Wars Beyond the Films with Mark Herleman and Cloud City Casino with Michael Morris over at StarWarsReport.com. Our recent episode of Cloud City Casino, which is a Star Wars gaming podcast, has dealt with things like the Bespin DLC for Battlefront and new announcements for X-Wing and Armada and such. We're actually recording later today as an episode specifically about LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens, so you get a chance to hear about that in the near future with impressions and bits about the news and whatnot that we've heard about the game so far. Just kind of a quick note here on the previous bits of this. Click a button. The first part of this stream, this Let's Play, got cut off. The power went out in the midst of it. There was a storm raging outside, and the power went out in the midst of the stream. And for those of you who were watching at the time, it was just an abrupt stop. That's why the video will be an abrupt stop as part one on the channel if you're watching the playlist I'm about to set up for this to be able to watch them straight through. I went back in, started up again once the power was back on, once the connection was restored, and continued on for a bit more. And we got to the point where we were done with the first couple of chapters, and that showed up as part two. I later went back and looked at YouTube, and it turns out that the power outage, while it killed the stream broadcasting from this end, YouTube didn't register that the stream was over, and instead kept on going until I started seeing people making asshole-ish comments and be like, what the hell's going on? Turns out, the stream kept going for about another 7.5 hours of black screen. Once I stopped it manually, it went through and processed, and once the processing was done, YouTube automatically cut off all the dead air. So part one should be as normal, but if you tried to jump into the stream a while back and saw some kind of weird thing where it was nothing but a black screen on the day that this game was released, that is why. It was a power outage and a YouTube thing not really syncing up with the fact that the system had stopped broadcasting. Alright, that said, we're going to continue where we left off. I do want to show you a couple of things here as we get going. Autosave has been enabled, and autosave saved my ass whenever it all went that day from the power outage. So our loading screens are basically location-based little playsets being put together. And yes, that's me moving it around. It's, in theory, it's just kind of sitting there. But that's no fun!
Wah, wah, wah.
Look, it's garbage!
Come on.
Hello, Andrew. And thank you, by the way. I did get... I finally saw the email come through, so we were actually able to use... part of your housewarming gift to get the guide coming for this game. So by Friday, I should have that guide, and I'll be able to be a little bit more deliberate in things like saying, hey, here's where you can find the different collectible pieces and whatnot. Something that I hadn't done for the game initially because I wasn't sure how much a guide would be necessary, and then realized how many collectibles there would happen to be. So, very cool. And you actually will have a small piece of the Star Wars room kind of in your name, in a sense, because what was left after picking up that guide, we used to pick up a specific Star Wars-themed, I don't even know what you call it, like a wall plate, so that whenever you go in and you turn on the light in the Star Wars room, it won't just have a generic switch there, it'll actually have a Star Wars-themed thing. So getting a chance to influence the room that's still coming together. Almost done, by the way. The 3D deco light for Kylo Ren has shown up. And that's on the wall now, so all we're waiting for is for that little light cover thing to come in the mail, and then I'll have that installed, and the room will basically be good to go. It'll be in its final form for whatever you want to call like this initial launch of it. So, yeah. I do want to show you guys something here. I'm trying to remember how you get to it. Okay, so if I go to like free play, I can do free play or replay story. It doesn't really matter where I go. But I wanted to show you that, of course, during free play, you get to choose the characters you're going to play with. And I wanted to show you where some of that DLC comes in. So we've got all these different ones that have been unlocked along the way thanks to just playing the game, right? I'm not sure why some of them are blinking as locked, because I've unlocked them, whatever. But if you go down to the bottom, we got custom characters you can create, which is kind of cool. I haven't done any of those yet. But you may recall that if you bought it through a pre-order, there's that Empire Strikes Back character pack that comes. And if you bought it initially, you would also have... I bought the Season Pass, you would already have that Jedi character pack. So that's where this comes in. I don't actually see a droid character pack yet. So I'm going to have to go through and look and see like what the heck is up with the droid thing. But the Empire Strikes Back has the Boba Fett prototype, Bosk, Dengar, Hoth Han Solo, Lobot, Hoth Luke, Hoth Leia, Ugnaught. And then the Jedi pack that apparently is the first thing coming through the Season Pass again, because it unlocked whenever I put in the Season Pass code, has Aayla Secura, Ki-Adi-Mundi, Kit Fisto, Luminara Unduli, Mace Windu, Plo Koon, Se-Si-Tin, and Shaak-Ti. Okay. And beyond that, you have your ships. Those are just ones that I've unlocked at different points, but apparently within that Empire Strikes Back pack is the Slave One, and within that Jedi pack is the Jedi Interceptor, the Actus Interceptor here. Eta 2 was the previous one. So anyway, I just wanted to show you that so that you knew kind of what was in those packs. I'm going to be just continuing the story itself, but that's what's in those packs for those who are curious about those. So we've gone through the opening, basically. And now we're just kind of following the markers to wherever the story's going to take us next.
Sinking sand. We'll have to use a speeder to get over it.
Okay. Now we got a new unlock here. Ooh, that's the Falcon. Holding down triangle and selecting whatever will allow you to choose Ray's speeder. That's Ray's speeder? This just means bring in a vehicle, because that sure wasn't a picture of a speeder up in that corner. BB on board. Ba-da-ts. All right, let's rock. Lego vehicles can be controlled with L, R2, and L2. Okay. Except that wasn't doing anything for me. What is this saying? Oh, maybe not. She jumps on. Okay, that was weird. Somehow. So the first thing, she was just like hanging on the side and not actually flying it. And did not know that Ray's speeder had guns on it. Perhaps that's just a Lego thing. Gathering up this. I don't think I'm actually in the level technically, though, so I don't think anything that I'm gathering right now is actually going to count towards Jedi status. Shit. I hate sand. It gets everywhere, and apparently it makes me sneeze. Oh, gotta sneeze again, I think. Jeez. Killing me. Alright, here we go.
Oh, hey, stop. New force field, kid. We put it up to keep out the raiders and the riffraff. I'd show you what I mean by riffraff, but I don't have a mirror with me.
Oh.
And if you think you can get past the force field, I'd love to see you try.
Keeping me out? Riffraff? Street rat? I don't buy that. Keep forgetting that. I keep pressing triangle as if triangle is an attack button. I'm so used to Disney Infinity at this point. Interestingly, the R2 button isn't doing anything for me. Usually R2 is going to be a duplicate of your attack button. There we go. I can build stuff in two places. I'll build something over here.
Thanks.
Oh, no, no, no!
Poor Rodians, always picking fights that they shouldn't. Like Greedo in the deleted scenes of The Phantom Menace, and the novelization of The Phantom Menace. which was Greedo the Elder, and then they decided with Clone Wars to make it actual Greedo, and
I'll
everything went to hell.
Down the overrides. Oh, I might have to do a little rebuilding.
Okay, well, I'm gonna build something over here now, because, you know, there's stuff to build.
Hey! I can reach the other from here.
Okay.
I am definitely gonna get fired because of this.
Okay.
Really,
she can throw her stick.
Come to the gate. It's probably half the reason we keep getting raided.
Okay, so she can throw the stick and turn it into I don't even know what you call that. She can turn it into a thing to grab. A bar.
Can you zap that, BB-8?
BB-8 be like, show enough. Yes, that is the voice of Daisy Ridley. Force Awakens, pretty much all the voices are the actors, believe it or not. Do I know who director Kennick is? You're talking about the dude from the military director dude that's now in Rogue One? Now that they finally given him a name? Yeah. Whew. I still feel like I gotta sneeze again. Hey, Blue Hat. If there's something I should call you other than simply Blue Hat, let me know. I know it's more of a name of a... it seems like more of like a name of an organization or a collective than an individual person's name. Am I beaming up to the Enterprise? Oh, okay, just continuing the story. That's what my plan was in the first place!
After crashing back down to the planet Jakku and fearing Poe is gone, Finn sets off across the arid desert in search of civilization. Well, of course he fears Poe is gone. He found Poe's torso!
Might recall that in the last time that he finds, instead of finding the jacket of Poe, he finds Poe's freaking Lego piece torso. I think that means Poe's dead, but of course he's not.
Sometime later, Rey and BB-8 arrive at Nima Outpost to sell salvaged components, not knowing that BB-8 is valued far more highly by sinister forces both inside and outside the settlement. Sometime later, there's that story group in action again, deciding they're not going to pin down when any of the damn stories take place in relation to each other. Am I right? Am I right? Eh?
When does the Lando comic series take place? It takes place between A New Hope and The Empire Strikes Back. No shit. When does the Lando comic book take place?
We don't know.
We don't want to constrain other authors, so we're just going to say it's in that gap and we can figure it out later.
Shit!
Recipe for disaster. Oh, cotton candy or ice cream. I guess it's ice cream. Looks kind of cotton candy-esque. Is that an old SD television? Keep it! Keep your SD television! It'll make it easier to watch your letterbox VHS of... Aw, shit.
What you brought me today is worth... One quarter portion.
Last week there were a half portion each.
What about the droid?
They're still doing this thing where for the most part the dialogue is correct to the film. Portions. But they're doing the goofy stuff as part of the way it's presented.
Actually, the droids are not for sale. Come on.
Follow the girl and get that droid.
Sorry, Unkar, you're just gonna have to fantasize that you've got the droid. You're just gonna have to go home and master BB-8. Ah, okay. That works. It's fun, Lazy Troy. I gotta say, it takes a little getting used to, though, because it's so different than a lot of the stuff I've played recently, barring Lego Dimensions, which I haven't played a whole lot, and it's...
Ow!
Hey, what? The jacket.
You know,
this droid says you stole it. Where'd you get it? Belongs to his master.
Belonged to Poe Dameron, right?
He was captured.
No running around
order.
And being beat with a stick. That's good, I guess.
Crashed. Poe didn't make it.
So you're with the Resistance?
Yes.
Obviously.
Yes, I am.
With the Resistance, yeah.
Yes.
I am with the Resistance.
This is what we look like. Well, some of us, not all of us.
Apparently he has a map that leads to Luke Skywalker and everyone's after it.
Didn't you think he was a myth? Never played Lego Avengers. I'm curious how well that worked, but I don't know. I've just... Lego games are usually not something I'm gravitating toward. It was the Doctor Who stuff that had me gravitate towards the Lego Dimensions stuff. Which is why, actually, after I finished the Lego pack, or the level pack for that, I haven't livestreamed more of it, even though I've got other packs and I'm not even through the story of it yet. It's all sitting... I kid you not, once everybody's backed off and not trying to kill me, I'll show you exactly what I mean. Yeah, so in front of me is a little table that I've got like my drink on and my iPad on. Under the table is this box. And this is nothing but Lego Dimension stuff, including a whole bunch of level pack characters and whatnot that I haven't even put together yet because I just haven't gone back to the game in quite a while. Break stuff! Break stuff! Yeah, it's interesting that the argument that, well, Rey is a real strong female character, whereas Leia, because she has to be rescued by the men at different points before she winds up taking charge of the rescue, and that she's the one captured and made the slave with the skimpy outfit and so forth, she's not really as strong a female lead as she was made out to be. I think it's a matter of the times, though, you know? I think it's a question of you know, you've got what constitutes a strong female character in the 70s versus what constitutes one, you know, 2015, 2016. We have to leave Padme out of the discussion because they pretty much deconstructed her character in episode 3 because they cut out most of her scenes. That's what I want to see. If they ever do a super-duper special edition or a special-er edition of the prequels beyond the slight changes for Blu-ray, I would love to see them add back in Padme's delegation scenes to essentially rehabilitate the character and make her a stronger character throughout the prequels instead of feeling like they kind of dropped the ball on her in that last one. Which is which? Let's try this. What the crap is this? Let me guess. BB-8? Nope. Oh! It's like a big ol' Ewok-esque weapon. Nifty, I guess. Hey! Let me alone! Rey's like, I may be having to fight a bunch of stormtroopers, but at least Finn isn't constantly trying to hold my hand.
That old Imperial shuttle's in the way.
It might still have enough juice in it to move.
Agreed, yeah. Assassin's Creed, zip it on the parkour stuff.
Yep.
What else can I... No, I don't want to build that. What else can I build? Apparently over here is the other one. Well, come on!
I'll need to get access to the cockpit.
Do I mind the Ewoks? There are times when I'm like, oh, you gotta be kidding with the Ewoks, but... I mean, for what Lucas was going for symbolically, that worked. All right, BB. Dang it, I was kind of hoping that BB-8 could do like a super jump kind of thing here, but he can't. Hey, it's Finn. FN2187.
How did
again,
you get access codes for an Imperial ship?
Matching. Easy matching, because you're just going until it's the right color. Again, utterly racist, right? Because the correct answer is always completely white. Anything that is a darker color than white is always wrong. Microaggression!
Over that way.
We're just gonna keep breaking stuff. Don't worry about it.
We found the droid!
I'm gonna keep shooting those little chickens until something happens. Come on. I'm waiting for the moment where a swarm of them come and try to kill me a la Zelda. other stuff to plug in. What? Yeah. What is your goal? Just blow stuff up. Get as many of the little thingamabobs as you possibly can. I don't like the fact that they disappear so quickly. That's always been something that's bothered me with the studs in LEGO games, that you have to collect them very, very quickly or they disappear, as if somehow the processor can't handle how many there are left. Man, put some clothes on! Kill you in your drawers. Woo! Anything else to blow up? No? Okay. Wait, is that two things? Yep, there's two things again that I can make. A shield. Okay. Great. I'm not sure why I needed that shield there. Maybe I'll need it for something else momentarily. What we got here? A soccer ball. The hell? Okay, it says... Okay, what again? Alright, so I got two options. I build it here. It will spit me out a soccer ball. Why is it spitting out a soccer ball? Why is it creating a shield? Tell you what, we'll just come back to that because that don't make any damn sense to me. Alright, let's send BB-8 through the thingy. Yeah. Go. Best LEGO game that I've played so far? Potentially this. Haven't played a ton of LEGO games. Played LEGO Star Wars games, played LEGO Indie, and a little bit of LEGO Dimensions. The variety of LEGO Dimensions is nice, though. But the fact that you have to stop in the midst of your gameplay to build stuff is a little bit frustrating. And the fact that they don't give you instructions on how to build the stuff outside of the game for most of it is a little frustrating. So you can't, like, pre-build something. And it makes it kind of frustrating when you're doing a live stream to hit a point where now you got to stop and build something before you can continue on. Get away!
Get away from me! Never misunderstand me! La la la!
Come on. Die, you bastards! Pa-ching! Alright, so... Here we go! Here we go! Whoa! Whoa! Gabby, whatever her name is, ladies and gentlemen. I forget, whoever the young girl was who just kicked all kinds of ass at the last Olympics. That's what I'm waiting for. I'm eager for the Olympics. It's one of the few sporting events I'll actually watch, but I'm not sure what I'll be able to even watch, given that... I mean, I guess we could watch on our HD little whatever you call it, like broadcast antenna thing, but we don't do cable anymore. Although I did just purchase a Screambox account, which is freaking awesome. It's like Netflix or Hulu, except it's specifically for horror movies. Nothing but horror movies. Alright, so I'm up here. There's this. But that is something Finn is going to have to deal with. So I got to figure out a way to get FN2187 up here. Nope. Go back to... how much did this cost? I want to say that the deluxe edition for PS4 was $70. And that includes the season pass and the what's supposed to be PlayStation exclusive content that so far I haven't seen, the droid character pack stuff. I'll have to see when that's accessible, how that's accessible, but I haven't actually taken the time to really look into it. Oh, there's more stuff. Oh no, it's just one of those stupid barrels. Okay, so he's got a grapple, she does not. Grapple must be attached to the blaster as it appears. Dump some more pieces. Okay. Get off us! Why are you wearing a sombrero? Is there a space Mexico? Yeah. I think it depends. If it's trying to tell a story, I prefer voice acting. If it's not, then I prefer not. If it's just like cutesy little scenarios or reenactments of something. And if the voice acting is done well, then good. But sometimes voice acting in video games can be garbage. And the garbage won't do in that case.
Anything over your side?
BB-8's like, I just got over here, asshole. Give me a second. Ah, no! Hitting incorrect controls. Open sesame! Not sesame. Sesame. In this case. Well, that must have been quite a shock! Oh wow, so BB-8 even has like a super attack of some kind. Alright, let's go back to...
Don't
go back
fall
to
in. Sinking sand.
Don't fall in. Whoa!
Boom! Yes, shakalakalakalaka.
Again, break stuff. I'm assuming I'm supposed to go back over there, actually, but I'm just over here whooping. Sorry! Was that Constable Zubio or one of his buddies? My bad. Or not Constable, what's the guy's name? The dude from, Weapon of a Jedi. Wait, are there multiples for this? No, just one. You can tell if there's just one versus multiple things that you can build into if it just starts building when you hit circle instead of having to, pick a direction first. I have no idea. I haven't been following much at all. I just like to watch it while it's actually airing. Come on! And she didn't wind up jumping back the opposite direction. How is there still stuff to break after she did her attack? Die, 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 die. Die, 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 my darling. It was what? Old Mega, not Mega, Metallic? Anything else to blow up? It always unnerves me when I hit something that's like 2 out of 3. I'm like, oh shit, what I miss.
Die, 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 my darling.
Okay, I gotta open that somehow, presumably. Break stuff! All these freaking studs going everywhere! Can't lose the studs. Not sure if I'm really caring about the whole get up to the point where you've gotten all of them and it does that funky whatever you call it, like the funky thing where it's got the like the light zipping around. I mean, I think Lego, I mean, they wanted to do something, and they didn't want to necessarily wait for a long time before there were more material, until there was more material, so it makes sense. Okay, I gotta do that with the Lugga Beast. I always kind of feel like the Lugga Beast is one of those names where you're like, yeah, it's a little too descriptive. Gee, it's a beast that lugs stuff. Duh. Wait, down. So we got a Lugabeast and a Happable.
Right here, BB-8. Stay close.
She hit that guy so hard, she knocked the helmet off of his ass. Hello. Hello, sorry. Now, is it that each one of these has to be taken out by a certain type of animal? No, apparently not.
Steady there.
A Jawa Bible or a Jawa Bible? As in, like, a Bible for Jawas or a translation of the Bible as if it was written by Jawas? Or a little bit of both? I have not heard what CNN is reporting right now, and yes, excited for Rogue One.
That's the way out.
Okay, so that's the way out. Okay, so let me make sure there's nothing else here that I want, because there's a chance that if I go for the way out, it's just gonna force me into it. Chris Christie's, well, of course, because, you know, Christie was the first to be like, sure, I'll jump. I'll join your team. What better support could there be than someone who looks dumbfounded at every single one of your press conferences? I guess, though. Book of Houtini.
Houtini.
What is this guy? Aside from apparently indestructible. Whoa! Half a boar going, or not half a boar, Lugabeast going airborne. Hello, what have we here? Hey, it's a thingy. The only one I found in this level so far. Alright, here we go.
Here we go. Here we go.
Washing machine. Them things are expensive, by the way. Not as expensive as some other friggin' utility. We had to buy a washer and dryer, a dishwasher, a stove, and a refrigerator for this place. Talk about some cash.
What?
TIE Fighters! What the? Oh, hopefully we'll get a nice little on-rails flying segment here. We need a pilot!
We have one!
You!
We've got to keep moving.
Sexist asshole. Although, of course, there's the there's all the Mary Sue. Why is Rey able to fly a starship? Rey's a junk dealer or a scavenger. Why should she be able to fly a starship? That's just stupid. Well, one, she says in the movie that she has flown. She just hasn't gone beyond the planet, like up into the atmosphere and into space. Or out of the atmosphere and into space. Two, we find out in stories like, what is a Rey actually? Why is it telling me Rey, like she can do something? Plus, we have the stories like Before the Awakening that reveals that she was using a salvaged Y-Wings flight simulator, essentially a computer as a flight simulator, to learn how to fly even before, you know, actually getting a chance to. So, yeah. Asked and answered, bitches! Take that Mary Sue comment elsewhere.
La, la, la.
I would argue that the question is not why are people so sexist about Rey, it would simply be why are people so sexist in freaking 2016. I'd like to think we're kind of fast past that point. Then again, I was like, they were past race being issues these days, but apparently not. So what the hell do I know? Okay, build! Two things to build. Let's build this. And this is a something. Oh, it's a cannon. With two ends. I will shoot you with my story group's cannon.
We'll have to go through the control tower.
Anything else blow up? Ooh, can I blow up a TIE fighter? Oh! Nah, screw it. Okay. Blow it up. Let's build whatever the other thing is. Which is a... What? Okay.
We've got to get through this wall.
So let's build...
Maybe there's a way over.
This? Hey, one of them dogs is attacking BB-8! And mutts? Stop it! I will electrocute you! Wait, was that it? What do you want? Characters like Hurricane Rider, blah, retire areas, okay. I would assume then that that's probably the next place I need to go, so let's see what else I can build. Hello, Emma? Let's see. You're eating? Okay. Okay. My bad. Meant to activate. Instead, I smashed it. Very much my approach to home improvement as well. Okay. It gave me that circle marker a second ago that would mean, hey, here's something that can actually do something. I'm just gonna run around a hitting circle, and that is. There we go! She's doing her Kratos impression here. Ooh, but I want that! I want it!
I want it! Why can't I jump on the rock? Sons of bitches, I wanted to jump on the rock!
She's now gonna go on a rampage because she couldn't jump on the rock.
Son of a bitch!
Oh, nope, that's a Chewbacca. Ain't got no Chewbacca. Yeah! Got that blue one. Oh, that's probably a fin. Got a grappling hook kind of thing. Yep!
Whee!
There's a way in up here, but it's blocked. Need a hand.
Okay! Let's go take stuff over here first. In Lego Star Wars, it's never about the mission. It's always about breaking shit first. Okay. You pushing or pulling?
Put your back into it.
Oh, no. How do I get behind there then? Because there's a blue stud back down. Answer, I probably don't. Okay. Great.
Whoosh. Oh, that sounded smashy.
Smashy? Alright, presumably this means it's BB-8 time. Oh, no, it's not. It's not BB-8 time? It's Rey time?
Yes, that should deal with the rule, alright.
Nah, it can't be. Fin time? Oh, it's fin time!
Yes,
it was an explosive.
Whoa.
Thought it was something I was supposed to latch onto, not just blow up. Microwave! Leia thought Han was bad firing in the. No, I'm destroying everything, actually. Thanks for the vote of confidence, Ray. Appreciate it. We gonna take this. We gonna stack it on now. And we gonna turn. Just through here. Whee! We'll take that quad jumper.
There's no way around. We're gonna have
great
to
Ray's theme stuff going on. Love the music from The Force Awakens.
Die, my ow.
You asshole. Stop it. Alright, well that ain't working.
There's a ship coming into land.
Kylo Ren is a Palby.
He's got a blaster turret.
That's kind of the whole point though of Kylo Ren. I like the fact that Kylo Ren is such a very different character than Vader and has so many obvious issues. Oh, and Finn is dead. Okay, there's gotta be somehow or another I gotta be able to get up there and get that. Or do something to it.
We've got more ships heading for us.
Oh, maybe not. Maybe it's just a matter of time. Waiting for the ability to take out the cannon somehow.
I think they shot something off those storage cases.
Oh shit, I need a BB-8!
Can you sabotage it from your side, BB-8?
Show enough! Oh, other way. One of them's got that thicker line on it. Oh, damn! BB-8 is like, this is for my grandpa Chopper. I'm gonna become a killing machine! Okay, I'm supposed to destroy more stuff. But as I'm destroying, I'm getting studs, so it kinda makes sense to just keep blowing stuff up. One more tie to destroy. Meantime, let's get some more studs. I'm assuming I'm getting studs. Actually, it looks more like they're just getting dropped out, but I'm not actually getting any because I'm not down there to collect it. There's a landing craft? Oh, this thing. Somehow, I'm supposed to destroy this thing. Like this tower. There we go.
We've got a chance. Run!
What about that ship on our right?
That one's garbage.
Time to recycle that garbage.
The garbage will do.
Yeah! True Jedi!
Only the second time I've pulled that off. The last level, I didn't pay that much attention to it and didn't get it. Whatever the escape level was. Escape the Finalizer or whatever. Anything over here? More studs! Because I want to be able to buy stuff later! It's giving me that Rey symbol. As if she is supposed to do something with it, or can do something with it, only... what can she do? I think that's a Rey symbol. It's kind of hard to tell. Whoa! Well, that didn't do me any good. I built a quad jumper, like, booster part, except the quad jumper flew away. Or the booster part flew away. Still getting that Rey symbol from time to time. Nope, okay. Whatever. Put your clothes on. This day and age, that is sexual harassment.
We can't take off with so many TIE fighters overhead.
It's a pity that missile turret's out of commission.
I'm not sure I can take that. Pardon me. Yeah. Now you know he's lying.
We're gonna have to connect it up to the generator over there.
Okay. There's something that can clear Lego mounds. Except it's not something or someone who's on my team right now. It's like a droid of some kind. Never can quite tell what you're smashing. Like what stuff is smashable and what stuff ain't.
Ain't smashable, what are you doing? Alright, I'll leave that alone. Okay. Let's try this. Hey! Stop shooting at me, dickwad!
What's that?
There we go.
They're used for finding electronic scrap buried in the sand. Which is cool. What we need to get that turret working.
Cool! Oh, so he just stands on it? You don't actually have to press anything? Lot of studs. I know there's one of these, like, way far over, if I remember correctly. Or another of those, way far over to the right. Did I miss any? Okay. Dun, dun, dun. Ooh, more stuff.
Yes, that should do the job.
Alright, well, we're gonna take care of this one over here first. Even if that's the one that'll do the job, because we did just unearth something over here. I mean, come on. Alright, and... collectible! Yay! So happy he's doing somersaults. Yay! Putting that stormtrooper training to good use. And let's see, we got two things we can build, so let's try this first. What the crap? Alright, well, that thing's kind of broken. Well, let's try the other one first.
BB-8, can you access that panel?
That's BB-8 saying, duh. Now let's see if we can make this thing work. There we go, that's what I'm talking about. Connect.
Oh, you in for it now, mother...
Do I get to jump into it? Yep. Nope. Come on. Triangle, triangle. There we go.
Die, 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 my former comrades.
It's so slow, though. Turret is so slow to move. You got your projectile lead time going on. Hey, Matthew.
I'm here!
Nice.
It's all broken.
Yes.
Yeah. I live in a blue world.
Wow, over here. I'm dating myself there. Look, everybody, it's garbage. Triangle.
Donna position is down there.
You ever fly this thing?
No. Nope. This ship hasn't flown in years.
I can do this. I can do this.
I can do this. I can do this.
It hasn't flown in years because it was stolen by... stolen by Duquesne and the Irving boys, then Unkar Plutt. And we don't exactly know when that happened because we're not entirely sure whether Han has the Millennium Falcon or not in Bloodline, but presumably he doesn't, because otherwise years would seem a little bit because it's 6 years for all of that to happen and for him to be away from it for so long. But that means we don't exactly know when the story takes place. It's the framing story of Smuggler's Run, thanks to that. But it's okay. Ambiguity is great. Die!
Nice shot!
I'm not entirely sure what I'm flying through these for, but okay, probably to get something at the end. Make sure I'm actually flying through these things. I think I missed one earlier.
There's too many of us. We'll never get through.
I can see a route. Maybe.
Yeah. Is what that glass bit sounds like. It sounds strange.
I think they sent the entire fleet after us.
Then you don't think their fleet is very big, and you're an idiot. Oh, I didn't know that. Gee, that's good to freaking know. Seriously, is that not the weakest little sound for the blasters, though? Like, where'd I learn to shoot like that? Oh, flying for the bad guys.
Nice shot.
Whee!
You're not making this easy.
It's too open out here.
Then find some more cover.
Okay, but remember, you asked for it.
Through.
Are you really doing this?
The Ravager. The Super Star Destroyer that Rae Sloan was so worried about getting her hands on. Or not Rae Sloan, the person who was opposing Rae Sloan in Aftermath, only for it to turn out that within a year it's crashed on Jakku anyways. Who gives a shit?
direction of the resistance bases need to know. If I'm taking you there, I need to know.
Shouldn't you be fixing stuff? Shouldn't he be asking you to get a boyfriend? Keep boyfriend?
Between us, I'm not worth the resistance, okay? I'm just trying to get away from the First Order. Would you tell us where the base is? I'll get you there first. Deal?
So where's your base? The Illenium system.
Yeah, the Illenium system, that's the one. Get us there as fast as you can.
Yeah, exactly. The car. As opposed to Jakar, who of course is on Babylon 5.
I feel it again. The pull to the light.
So you're a moth.
Supreme Leader senses it. Show me again. The power of the darkness. And I will let nothing stand in our way. Show me. Grandfather.
It's like Trump getting ready for his campaign.
Show me the darkness.
Sir, we were unable to acquire the droid on Jakku. It escaped capture aboard a stolen Carillion YT model freighter.
The droid stole a freighter.
He's got a Star Wars room too. Yeah.
It had help.
FM-2187.
The two were accompanied by a girl.
What girl?
What girl?
Freaking their own shit. Favorite Star Wars character depends. Are we talking legends, canon, or films? Let's see. No, I've answered that question before, but I don't think to this particular group.
True Jedi!
Yes, that's right. I'm a liberal douche because I think Trump is out of his fucking mind. Actually, if anything, I'm a libertarian. Anyone who's watched the stream has probably figured that out by now. Because I tend to agree on personal liberty issues with liberals. I tend to agree on personal liberty issues with conservatives, depending on which one's going for what particular personal liberty at the time. I think that in this election, we're dealing with basically two... your choice between an authoritarian... confirmed pathological liar on one side or an authoritarian confirmed pathological liar on the other side. As Aliens vs. Predator said, whoever wins, we lose. But that's fine. Go on with your butt hurt. No problem. Do I like mortars? Not really use them in most of the games that I play. So on Wikipedia, the ship in Part 2 wasn't the Azure Angel. It's Ackbar's personal ship called Daisy May. Oh, the one from... from Droid Tales. Interesting. I would think it was... Well, I mean, they were designed very similarly. I'm curious to see if that was an intentional reference when they made the Daisy May to be that. It's been a long time since I've seen the Droid Tales stuff.
I think he's over there.
Interesting, though.
Leave it to me.
Kind of sucks that it's not the Azure Angel. That would have been a great reference. But, well, I can see it. We just got this ship, so I'm just going to tear up everything inside it. Surely the original owners aren't going to somehow track us because as soon as we took off, there was a tracking device that activated or anything like that. I mean, seriously. A politics podcast. We'll put it this way. My interest in doing podcasts in general tends to a lot of times come down to a question of whether or not I have to be the one editing them. Because the time, I don't tend to have the time to do so most of the time. So, if it's something where I'm coming on and somebody else is essentially spearheading producing, like with, let's say, Michael for Cloud City Casino, then I'm generally for it if I've got the time to actually record. So it just kind of depends. And politics would be an interesting one because I talk about it a lot and I'm interested in it, but at the same time, I also teach government and I... From the student standpoint, anytime I'm interacting with students, I try to keep my personal views completely out of it so that it's more showing them how to do critical thinking as opposed to telling them what to think. So, make sure I didn't miss anything. So, putting into a podcast, is it worthwhile or not? Yeah. But then again, it's not like it isn't coming up here.
I mean, can you get the bulkhead open?
Oh, fireworks! Mortar fireworks! Haven't tried them myself. I think they're cool to look at. I've never used them myself. We're not going to do any kind of firework stuff here, if only because we're aside from our 45-degree angle yard, we have woods behind us for quite a while. and we'd rather not accidentally burn our house down by catching the woods on fire. What we got? A bunch of gas that's gonna kill us.
What is that?
Oh no, the propulsion tank must have overflowed. The gas is poisonous, try not to breathe it. There's a respirator on the back wall in there. Can you hook it with your grapple fin?
Okay.
To fill the chamber with poisonous gas! Okay. How did you know there was something
right
in there that could be used?
I'll find the vent controls.
Had you just been on the ship and, like, looked around before? Little sneaky thing. Wasn't this just where I was? Got his own Vader breathing. I love that.
The automatic cycle is jammed. I'll have to use the manual one.
Okay. You do that. Stick it! Good thing Ray's got a stick. That stick is good for a lot of things, apparently. First Lego Star Wars game with full voiceover? Yes. Just not the first Lego game with full voiceover. I keep thinking I'm gonna fall down there, but it's just like a reflective surface, apparently. Nope, follow the dots, damn it. Follow the dots. Oh, it's a ding. Make sure that my ding does not represent somebody needing a retake, which it does not. Whoa! What's over here? Oh, back to kind of the same little area. Well, yeah! Because Jakku in Battlefront is, you know, rendered to look somewhat realistic. Oh, I was like, whoa, is it a force field stopping me from getting by? We're smarter than this. Oh, no, it's the continue story thing. As copyrighted music, it puts a copyright notice on it, but it allows basically just the owner of the musical rights, the music distribution rights, to put advertisements on here instead of me, and whatnot, and to collect stats on the video and how many times it's watched and things like that. But sometimes it blocks it in certain countries, and I think Canada is one that, for instance, Battlefront stuff was blocked, or Disney Infinity stuff
controls.
Was blocked.
All controls are overridden.
But how could I do this without the music?
Get off!
Oh no.
What do we do? There must be someone.
Hide!
We're home.
Oh, maybe not. Maybe they're not hiding.
Where's the pilot?
I'm the pilot.
You?
Sexist!
From a cop plot. He stole it from the Irving boys who stole it from Duquesne.
Who stole it from
him? Stole it from me.
At some undetermined point in time, perhaps before, perhaps after Bloodline.
Stole back the Millennium Falcon for good.
This is a Millennium Falcon. You're Han Solo.
Aren't you going to say you used to be? You're not supposed to take pride in it. You're supposed
this
to be like, I'm not
to
really
get
him anymore.
Space as soon as possible.
He's carrying a map to Luke Skywalker.
Again, it's a map to the first Jedi Temple, which is where everybody believes that Luke has gone, but, you know, same thing. You're hauling CGI creatures? Oh, you're an idiot!
It's the Guavian death game. Must have tracked us from Nantoon.
Insert hackneyed CGI creature chase that brings down the entire film, just like what J.J. Abrams did with Star Trek 2009. Here.
What about BB-8?
Stays with me until I get rid of the gang. I can have him back and be on your way.
Han Solo, you're a dead man.
Volatique.
You're from space.
What's the problem?
Ireland or Scotland?
The problem is we loaned you 50,000 for
Scotland,
this job.
Right?
You think hunting Rathgars is cheap?
Panja Club wants their investment back too.
I never made a deal with Kanja
Club. Oh, please have the line.
Tell that to Kanja Club.
Yes!
That BB unit, First Order is looking for one just like it. And two fugitives.
If we close the blast doors in that corridor, we can track both gangs.
This does play out slightly differently in the novelization. I'm trying to remember. It's like one is the wrong fuses, but there was something else in how she dealt with it in the novelization that wasn't quite as durr as wrong fuses, but still had the same result. Up! Knock your hair right off your head. Careful, Harrison Ford! You'll get yourself killed while filming this movie. Damn!
Falcon's not far. Just a few quarters away.
Here's some Guavian Death Gang dudes. Stop it, Balatique! Or is that a Kanji Club guy? Oh, shit! He just bitch-slapped Han Solo to death! I thought only Leia could do that. I would almost pay to ride one of those if it was, like, outside the grocery store or something. Okay. Whoa! Especially if it spewed out money like that. I mean, damn. The hub for levels, it's like multiple hubs. It's like after every mission, there is a portion where you're still on that planet or wherever you ended the story, and then you're like moving on, and you have to go to the little weird area that looks like you're trapped in a ray shield to be able to actually continue the story. So it's not a hub world per se.
Let me check. Make sure there isn't anything dangerous in them.
And somehow, again, by using binoculars, I'm not just going to see something. I'm going to change and activate something.
Forged currency. Blow them up, Chewie.
Priceless antiques and forged currency. Forged currency? Han, you asshole. Give it to Chewie, damn it! Boom! Chewie got some explosives. Ah, crap, it's Tasu Leech. And his guys, who come with the Lego Millennium Falcon, by the way. That's one of my, one of the things that I did for my Star Wars bookshelves, or not bookshelves, the home video shelves, was I picked up the Force Awakens, Special Forces TIE Fighter, Millennium Falcon, and Poe's X-Wing. Which I then put together and put on top of those shelves, so now they're in there as part of the Star Wars room.
Hope your friends are still alive, BB-8.
Sounds like they're fighting up there.
They have BB-8. Careful, it's poisonous.
Was that your finally owned freaking training experience?
Although no real protection against those other things.
I should be okay. Yeah, I should be able to walk through. Because I have my Vader mask and stuff. Not that flammable. I can shoot shit, it won't explode. I need a protocol droid for that one. Okay. and it's so weird. It's not really. Sometimes it actually means just go L in circles over and over again. Sometimes it means follow exactly where it is on the circle. There seems to be little rhyme or reason as to why each one does what it does. Ooh, Mark.
Money, 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 money.
Studs are
money. Whee!
That's that force jump right there. If that doesn't prove that she's force sensitive immediately, I don't know what does.
Whee! Whee!
Whoa! Yep. That I am. This is stream numero tres. Oh my god! Run! It's overused CGI! Escape!
Let's see if I can get it open.
I'm kind of... It is interesting that they use Wrath-Tars, even though they already had the Vlixis creature that existed in... that existed in Clone Wars that theoretically they could have used in place of Wrath-Tars because they're very similar creatures. But it says, like, nah, we're gonna make something new. Gotta stick my stick in it.
I am the God of War!
Have they gotten harder over time? Yeah. No. I think that the in trying to become more and more creative with their puzzles, they've had a tendency to become ambiguous sometimes with the puzzles that leads to some frustration. Like, particularly on LEGO Dimensions, when I was doing some of the stuff for the Doctor Who level, there were times I was like, what the hell am I doing? And I was walking around in circles for a good 20 minutes before figuring out what I was supposed to do because the puzzles are not well explained. So...
Hit it!
Hola, Star Wars fan. Hola, Linda. Got it! Nope, don't got it.
Where's that going?
Stop shooting shit on Han's ship!
I don't care how it happened, I'm just happy it did.
Oh,
unless
okay.
Unless you want to be an appetizer for a Wrath-Tar, then I suggest you move.
Character thermal detonators can throw it on silver. Okay, then I need to switch characters.
This can be a bigger problem than us, Chewie.
Can I not be Chewbacca? Why can I not be Chewbacca? BB-8, I have Han. And it's telling me that I need Chewbacca to blow up the silver stuff. Hey, I mean, where the hell is Chewie? Nothing I'm doing is gonna allow me to jump for Chewie. What? Yeah, I freaking know that. Characters with thermal detonators. Okay. So where is my character with the thermal detonator now? Where the hell is Chewie so that I can use him to blow that up? Oh! Killed again. Oh my god, I know this. Can I choose Chewie? Oh, okay. Thank you. I haven't used that yet because for the most part we've had such a small number of characters in play. I haven't actually used the wheel at all for character selection. Woo! No, not BB-8. Wrong button. I was trying to use the triangle or... L1R1s that let you cycle. Okay, Han. Yeah, let's figure out what's going on. Well, since the ship's already being torn up and we're going to have to escape momentarily anyway, I'm going to go ahead and blow up and destroy a bunch of my own stuff to get some extra cash. Sound good to you, Chewie?
It's stuck.
No problem, Blue Hat. Have a good one.
We can't get down to the breaker.
Why are there creatures in my ship? And why were they hiding the red brick? Not that I have a problem, because now I got the red bricks. Oh, cool! Somehow Han just... How'd I slide? Huh, okay, whatever. Korea's like, I got this! Yo! Zap everything with electricity. Yep. Which about the moment that's the first Star Wars Lego game to have actual voice work, but not the first Lego game to have voice work. Use L to control the cursor and square to interact machinery. Okay. What am I doing? Okay. Okay. And then there are some puzzles that have you like, really? Did something happen and my brain became dead? It's not that we want to insert intelligence. It's just that we want to intelligence. Notice the music. Bop!
The fuse is blown. We're gonna need a new one.
Okay. Well, it just so happens that a new fuse just popped right out. Okay, I gotta destroy it and pull out a fuse. Looks very much like the fuse is in my car. At least my old car. I don't think I've messed around with the fuses in the Kia, but in my Mustang back in the day, before it got totaled. Yes. That kind of fuse. That what do they look like was originally meant to actually be a who am I playing as? Okay, I'm playing Smith. Was meant to actually be a line in the film, or was it just like they were playing against a blue screen and she's just like, what are they supposed to look like? I don't know. You'll see what they look like when everybody else does when the movie comes out. Damn, I missed the blue one. Yep, not gonna be True Jedi in this time.
I see a bulkhead up ahead. Keep running.
Still missed it.
Yeah, I should have brought company. Get that bulkhead shut.
We have to build something to tie up that tentacle.
How's about you stop telling me what to do, Han Solo? You won't be the boss of me until you eventually,
come on,
you know.
Hurry!
Try to. What in the hell? The hell? I would ask why Han has something that has like a dancing holographic dude on it, but given what that Chewbacca has the VR, Chewbacca's family, his dad, has the VR headset that apparently has him getting off to Diane Carroll or whoever it was, I'm not even gonna ask. Okay, so what am I doing with this now? Up! Aside from breaking it, apparently. What to say? Strong characters can pull certain handles. Okay. up. Okay. Interesting. Build him a... Okay, so then what the heck is this? Unless it's something I gotta deal with in a moment. I'm assuming now I gotta rebuild this to draw him in to get zapped.
Ship now?
So yeah, what was that that I just built? Something to help me get off the ship? What the? Okay. Yusa making no sense, eh? Come on, Han.
This way.
Are you sure?
Take the droid.
Are you still alive, Palatine? Dinner time. Again, they're called blast doors because they're supposed to protect you from a blast. Not so that you shoot it or blast it and the door closes or opens. It's not what it means. So now he doesn't get shot because it's a Lego game. Now he gets something dropped on him. And this has been an ongoing discussion now, JL, on the... pages for the Timeline Gold and Star Wars Beyond the Films on Facebook, but suffice to say, what Mace says, or what Mace says, what Samuel L. Jackson says about Mace living is meaningless. And it's him as a fan who was involved saying, kind of having wishful thinking, the same way that George Lucas saying years ago that maybe Mace survived is also meaningless at this point because he sold off the rights to the property. What'll make the difference is what Disney or a member of the Lucasfilm Story Group says about it. And the Lucasfilm Story Group member, Pablo Hidalgo, has basically said, no, he's dead. So, it's over! He is most definitely dead as far as canon is concerned. But the fact that Lucas's say as the creator means nothing anymore has caused a lot of people to get quite butthurt over the issue.
Any more cargo
but,
like that?
Yeah, he sold off his rights to the franchise.
One of the delivery
That's
control
kind of
panels
the point.
Is up there.
When you sell off the rights to something, you lose the ability to be the one making those kinds of calls because you sold off the rights. Now, personally, I think it'd be odd if he was still alive, but I know that that Michael Morris, my fellow host of Cloud City Casino, he would love the idea of Mace Windu being alive, since we don't see a body. But, you know, it doesn't really mean anything yet. Okay, so am I climbing up the wall? No, I'm not climbing up the wall. Am I shooting the wall? Smacking the wall? Am I building this into something else?
Oh,
James Cameron's like, I was underwhelmed. Okay. Doesn't really mean anything, but all right. All right, so, oh, there's one of those under there, too. Can I get under there? I need Darth Vader to pull that out of the way, so that'll be a free play thing. All right. What in the hell? So I guess that's not going to do anything until I move this somehow out of the way. So am I back to BB-8 again? Because he zapped it. Can't do anything there because he's not Luke. Can't do anything here because he's not Rey. Can't climb up because he's not Rey. Okay. This should only work for... Like, she's not going to be able to grab that. I think we've just hit one of those puzzles that should be deceptively simple but are going to leave me for 20 minutes trying to figure out what the hell I'm supposed to do, like I was talking about before. So, okay, so it switched. Any chance we can get Rey down from there, or am I going to have to do a checkpoint restart or something? Ah, there we go. Okay, so apparently I must be having to do something with that. I'm assuming is that creating a climbing wall for Rey when it's turned on? Yes, it does. Okay, that's what I was looking for. Never seen Wreck-It Ralph. Do like Zootopia, but never seen Wreck-It Ralph. No idea how much Mark Hamill was.
Kratos!
Okay. Okay, need BB-8 again. Balls, which means I need to blow this thing up. Build it again. Oh yeah, and BB-8 can't actually build, I don't think.
Kaboom!
Alright. Do his silly matching game. He is on buzz from it. Energy! And... opened up a new thingy that'll let those things, I'm assuming I'll be knocking one off onto a Raftar or something. But now I need Han up here. And I don't know if there's a way to actually get Han up there. Yet. Okay. Oh, there's one. Pass it to Finn, and he can do his little lock-on. Boom!
Oh, yeah. We need more stuff like that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Okay. Has it been confirmed that Lando's coming back, or is that just sort of wishful thinking, fan speculation stuff? Or Fett, as the case may be. Okay, hit it! Alright, time to somehow manipulate the environment just by looking at it. Okay. That is a chewy explosive thing, I believe. Kaboom! Han is just tearing his own ship up.
Again. Smuggler.
Again. Jackass. And no, Creepinator Mace Windu is not still alive. Pablo Hidalgo has confirmed he is not still alive. It does not matter that Samuel L. Jackson would like it to be so. It doesn't matter that Lucas said that it is potentially possible to be so. Lucas doesn't have a say anymore. And Jackson never had a say. Hidalgo and the story group, they do get to make that decision, and their answer was nope.
Gotta light him up. Left to right.
Oh, well, now we gotta... Okay, well, way to tell me it has to be left to right. The first time... Oh, and there is a far left. Okay. Which reminds me, what happened to the person who called me a liberal douche? Did he just decide, you know, ah, shit, I fucked up. I guess I shouldn't have said liberal douche because I didn't know what the fuck I was talking about. Did he just, like, disappear? Or did he just go silent? Alright, you said left to right. So I guess it's not left to right of these, it's left to right of those. The green one has to go before the yellow one. Way to, to make it clear. Come on. There we go. Walking over, hitting circle, and he's not doing anything. Ah, dumbass. My bad. Oh, it did work. It just worked super, super fast. Okay. Now, if I get up there. Nope. Oh, there's a BB-8 coming there. Okay, BB. Go get me that collectible, boy. Yeah. All right, and let me guess. Oh, I was thinking it was a chewy explosive thing. It wasn't. It was just a regular one to blow up. Ah, but would Mace have known how to do it? Because in canon now, it's a special talent. Crab droid! You get a lot of those on your ship if your ship has unprotected docking with other ships a lot. You wind up with some crab droids. What's he doing? Oh, he's gonna spray water in its face and get destroyed. Well,
delivery rail up there. If you can get that lift working.
I'm telling you. I don't remember them being on the ship this long in the movie. And this one is not so much a, when he grabs something, it's not so much the keep it in the area as with BB-8, it's more of a, when it's in the area, hit circle and it locks in. With no explanation that it's a different mechanic at all. Whoa! Chewie's like, I will kill all of y'all humans! And booyah!
Quickly! Build, build, build!
Quickly! Build, build, build!
Aim for the soft, fleshy parts.
So, like, shoot him in the balls? Hit him in the nards! Raptors don't have nards! Just do it! Raptors got nards! Hopefully there's someone of my generation who has the slightest idea what movie I was just referencing.
Horses of evil must beware of the monster squad.
You, close the door behind us. You take care of Chewie.
Watch the thrust. We're going out of here at light speed.
That's crazy.
From inside the hangar, is that even possible?
Balatique, you're standing in poisonous gas. Boom!
Inform the First Order that Han Solo has the droid they want.
and it's aboard the Millennium Falcon.
You mean so that Supreme Leader Snoke can have a rather awkward conversation in which he says, "Your father, Han Solo," as if he doesn't know who his father is?
Leading them to the last Jedi.
That's one big minifig.
If Skywalker...
Macrophage.
The new Jedi will rise.
Supreme Leader, I take full responsibility.
General! Our strategy must now change.
The weapon, it is ready. I believe the time has come to use it. We shall destroy the government that supports the Resistance, the Republic.
Because without you had to clarify that it was a Republic them, to them, like they didn't
know. The
Resistance
will be vulnerable, and we will stop them before they reach Skywalker.
Go. Oversee preparations.
Like his dismissiveness in the film when
there
he says that, it's
an
like it's
awakening. Have you felt it?
Yes.
There's something more.
Yep.
The droid we seek is aboard the Millennium Falcon. In the hands of your father, Han Solo.
That's who my father is?
He means nothing to me.
Durr.
We shall see.
Why does Snoke need to say it, and what a really kind of dull way of making that revelation in the film. I really wish they had revealed it in some other way that was a little more dramatic. Level complete. Free play unlocked. Red brick. What you got there? Some kind of box, huh? Aravana now added. Guavian Marauder. Aravana Microfighter. Guavian Microfighter. Sweet. Chewie! Wounded. Got Han Solo. Balatik. Kokin Shan, Guavian Gunner, Guavian Security Soldier, Kanji Club Gang Member, Kanji Club Sniper, how about Tazu Leech? Razu Oin Free, there you go, Tazu Leech, Bo Zhang Litro. New level discovered, Wrathtar Hunting. Nifty. Cool. Okay, so... now I'm kind of curious how this is supposed to work. So back on the Millennium Falcon. My plan is to wrap up at this point, but I do want to see a little bit here. I guess that's the mini fighter of the Falcon. All right, so yes, we're back
jumping
on...
out of the inside of another ship wasn't so smart after all.
So we're back
I'm
to being
have
a
to
hub
sort
again.
This mess out here. Go check on the forward maintenance bay. I got a weird power drain showing up in there.
Yeah, that's fine. I'm trying to recall now, as far as, like, being able to go back to, like, the Resistance base or whatever, as far as, like, for instance, last night, apparently, as the, night before when the stream was ending, it made a new mission available, which was the, I believe it's the, that new adding to the saga, Lorsan Tekka mission. But I'm not entirely sure how you access it yet, because I haven't actually done anything with it yet. I'm wondering what talking to... maybe talking to Han is the thing that's going to activate the... not activate, but make it accessible for me to be able to do that other thing they were just talking about. That would make sense.
Who is this?
You want to hear all about those Wrathtars, huh?
Mm-hmm.
You want to hear all about those
okay,
Wrathtars,
yeah. So,
huh?
Presumably by getting 30 of these, it unlocks the ability to play that Wrathtar hunting mission. So I would assume that if I went back to Jakku, then I would see something similar that is designed specifically to allow to play that Lorsan Tekka mission. I'll know better tomorrow tomorrow. Today's Thursday. I'll know better tomorrow because my guide should be showing up tomorrow. Courtesy of, again, if you didn't see the beginning of the stream here, one of the stream viewers who is actually somebody who I worked with a little bit in the past and who I had a chance to get to know years ago when he was a listener to my podcast and launched his own podcast called Star Wars in the Beginning. Andrew Bettis decided to send my wife and I a housewarming gift through the by way of an Amazon gift card, and we were able to use that for a Star Wars light switch plate that'll go in the Star Wars room, and on top of it, though, being able to order the guide for this game so I can be a little bit more instructive rather than just straight up let's play as I'm playing, which should arrive, thanks to Amazon Prime, should arrive tomorrow, I believe. So we'll kind of see where things go from there. I will show you these codes real quick if I can pull them up. If you can handle me stepping away from the system here for a second to pull up the codes. But there is a little thing. There's a little thing inside the instruction booklet that has go to this website, take this survey for LEGO, and we will give you specific cheat codes, so to speak, codes to unlock things within the game. Though I'm not sure if the codes will unlock them perpetually or they just unlock them for that particular play session. We'll see. But you've got two things you can unlock here. We have P8KXSA. So P8KXSA, which will unlock 9NUM. Okay. And then you've got another code, which is VVVSEA. Easier to do. Sorry, I was walking over to the computer where I had typed those, that I had copied and pasted those. VVV, Sony Entertainment America. And you got R2QE5, which are now unlocked as minifigures to play with. So now my count is at 39. I guess the question is whether or not that stays up there. We shall see, but I'm going to go ahead and bail on out of here. All righty. That's slow moving. Again, I'm not entirely sure why it's a rebel symbol and not a resistance symbol. They're similar, but not exactly the same. But whatever. Let me go ahead and head on out of here. So the final spiel, as always. Of course, this has been Nathan Butler. This is my channel. On this channel, you'll find From the Star Wars Home Video Library, with the most recent episode being the bonus lightsaber DVD from 2007. Talking about all the different Star Wars home video stuff for the U.S. and a few from beyond. We, of course, have on the channel a guide to Disney Infinity for Star Wars fans, including Let's Plays of all of the Star Wars play sets for Disney Infinity 3.0, along with Fantasy Flight Games reviews and whatnot. You can find my Star Wars Timeline Gold, the most comprehensive Star Wars chronology available anywhere, over at StarWarsFanWars.com/timeline. You can find the two podcasts I'm involved with, Cloud City Casino with Michael Morris and Star Wars Beyond the Films with Mark Herleman, both at StarWarsReport.com. Cloud City Casino actually just had a release of our episode about E3 and Bespin DLC for Battlefront, plus new news for X-Wing, new news for Armada and whatnot. And we're actually tonight here in about probably an hour and a half, we're going to be recording our episode that'll be released early next week. That's going to include our coverage talking about first impressions and whatnot for LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. So if you're curious about our thoughts on that, for both me and Michael, who does have the game also, same deluxe edition for PS4, be sure to check that out. New episode should be released. I think he's aiming for Mondays now. So we shall see it. But again, he's the editor, so it's up to when he gets it edited as opposed to me. Thank God, because that's a lot of stuff. But thank you all for watching. I really appreciate it. Be doing another one of these streams probably tomorrow. And we'll see about Saturday, possibly. We'll just have to see. But probably tomorrow, we'll be back with some more LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens. As for Battlefront, near future, but I want to focus on LEGO Star Wars The Force Awakens at least for now. So, thank you all. I appreciate you watching. I enjoyed the chat. Hopefully you'll get a chance to check it out in the future again. And take care, everybody. I'll see you soon.